Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we continue our trap series. I want to show you how to create sublayers. This is the stuff that the pros know. It creates movement in your track so that your track doesn't feel like it's being stuck or getting stuck at certain points. So I'm using VocalSynth for things that aren't even vocals, and I'll show you how to use it in a masterful level as far as creating your own sound. So for example, I have my 808, my kick, and my hi-hats all directly sent as a duplicate over to this sound effects channel. And they're running through pure VocalSynth 2. Now, here's without the sound. So I want you to listen to it before and then after. So here's before. Show you how to introduce that movement. And movement in modern day trap, you have more than just the linear hi-hat that goes you could do a bunch of hi-hat rolls, but most likely you're going to hear in the top tracks two hi-hats going on, and this is how you create that sub rhythm. So VocalSynth 2, we're going to turn it on here, and I have the 808 routed to this track, okay, and I have the kick routed. So here's with no hi-hats. It's creating its own percussion element. Let's run the kick through it. Okay, so the reason why you don't hear so much bass is if you turn off this filter, you'll hear the low end. So if I turn this filter off, you'll hear frequencies that compete against the kick. So what I did, the most important components for this setup, and you could take a picture of the settings if you want. The most important components are the shred, okay, and I have the A setting on 1/8, B setting on 1/32nd, the C setting on 1/16th. So that's the only dynamic thing you can't really screenshot. However, the filter is super important for this sound because we're getting rid of the bass stuff and we're only leaving the high frequency stuff. So I have mine set to a New York, I'm assuming NY stands for New York, HP, which is high pass filter, and I have it set to 370 hertz and below. So everything below 370 hertz is being cut, and then I just click and randomize the knobs up here. It's going through and moving stuff until it sounded right, and this is the tone that I like specifically for this track, okay? And that's what makes this creative. It creates a sub layer based on the source sound, so we don't even have to introduce a new sound source as far as like a raw sound. No extra, there's no other hi-hat I'm using. Let's A-B it one more time. Here's without. Pretty plain and kind of standard. Now here's with. Makes the beat feel like it's not predictable, and that's the issue with most beginner beats, is that it sounds too predictable, or it sounds like the beat's getting stuck because the high frequency stuff isn't moving enough. And this is my way of creating that for trap, and trap is all about figuring out new ways to take what we've done before, like playing linear, and just changing and flipping the whole industry on its head. And this is a pure example of that. So thanks for watching today. It's BusyWorksBeats.com.